this means the bacteria have some property of excreting the oxidation reduction enzymes. So this enzymes will reduce the nanomaterials precursor and gives into the nanoparticle. So this particular hypothesis I have created and then I have studied various approaches. So for this, if we want to enter into the nano, I just want to have an understanding of nano characterization. So I got exposure to understand what are the characterization techniques that I have to study before going to tell that this is a nano or not. So there are various techniques behind this nanoparticle. So once successfully synthesis the nanoparticle, then I have to confirm whether it is a layout or not, whether this is a nanoparticle size range or not, and it has the particular application part. So these things will be useful only with high nano characterization test. That facility we have the received in the PLC, and then I studied is the transmission electron microscope. Simply by visible optical microscope, we are able to get any pictures of the atomic or nanostructures. So for that, we need electron microscopy structures. So I started studying about the electron microscopy, and then I subjected this particular nanomaterials into the electron microscopy, and then I started getting various images. This electron microscope reveals that my material is a nanomaterial, and also the particular ELACs and all the structures reveals that this fat and all the structures confirm that my material is UTA. So almost the microbiological proof of developing nanomaterials as well as the characterization that I have understood briefly. The problem is that I have successfully developed the materials, but the main problem statement is that I have to remove fluoride and nitrate from the drinking water. I cannot simply put this powder into the water, I cannot remove this. So say for example, the main problem is the real-time flow is groundwater. So in groundwater, I have to develop some portable filtration unit or something like that, so that I can incorporate this nanomaterial into that. I have to design a filter, then I have to incorporate this nanomaterial into the design filter, then I have to make a setting. Generally, I can wash the water and I can get a clean one. So once after successfully developing nanomaterial, I have thinking in the different opportunities how I can implement my nanomaterial into the filtration system. So there comes the idea of implementing these nanoparticles into the fiber systems, where this nanofiber itself has the filtration capacity. So I just started working on what nanofiber is, how the membrane will act in the water filtration system. So that again the channel opens and what ideas and insights about the nanofiber membranes. And also the second important thing is activated carbon-based proteins. So this is also a good mode of property and a good absorption property of the water treatment application. So in this is another subject where I can impregnate my nanomaterials into the system. And the third one is the microorganisms. Even the microorganisms will act as a filtration system where I can incorporate these nanomaterials into the bacteria. I can homogenize, I can make a film, where that particular film also will act as a filtration. And the final is ceramic membranes. This particular normal filter candle, there will be a white color candle. So in steel, something like that, particular common with the ceramic membrane. So these are all the substrates where I can implement my nanomaterials in the system, I can develop my own filtration system. Then after completing my initial studies, the result comes with a not very good results. So it absorbs only nitrate, not fluoride. So I have to develop a system where I have to deal with both fluoride and nitrate. So my particular DOT works only with the nitrate. It is unable to absorb fluoride particle. So I just started working on modifying of this DOT with the aluminum. So there I developed a hybrid chemical and biosystems where I am working on this aluminum based substance which has a widely reported studies of fluoride. Then I started making this aluminum system, and then I combined it with this nanofiber membrane as a template. So I developed the DAO2 and then modified with aluminum, then particular compound I fixed into the nanofiber membrane, and finally I prepared a sheet like substance where the particular sheet will act as a filtration system for the removal of fluoride and nitrate. So DAO2 will take care of nitrate part and aluminum will take care of fluoride. So I will show you how they developed that particular nanofiber membrane. So this is the nanofiber of microscope.